The goal of this video is to discuss how the parasympathetic nervous system and its innervation to the SA and AV nodes in the heart can regulate heart rate. The vagus nerve innervates the SA and AV nodes of the heart. So here they are located, SA node and the AV node. Okay, remember the vagus nerve is a parasympathetic nerve. When the parasympathetic nervous system predominates, the neurotransmitter that gets released by the vagus nerve is going to be acetylcholine. Remember, parasympathetic nervous system, always correlate that with acetylcholine. To what type of receptor will acetylcholine bind to? The receptors that are at the SA and the AV nodes, meaning the effector, right, are the muscarinic cholinergic receptors. And where in the heart are these located? Well, they have to be at the SA and the AV node because acetylcholine is being released at that location, and therefore the acetylcholine must bind to these receptors. When the neurotransmitter binds to these receptors, what effect will it have? Well, it's going to lower the heart rate. And remember, these are muscarinic cholinergic receptors and therefore generating slow responses. And what I would like to do now is think about what's the mechanism for how the parasympathetic nervous system lowers heart rate. First off, let's talk about what cell types in the heart regulate heart rate. Hopefully, you answered pacemaker cells, which are also called autorhythmic cells. And so what kind of potential do pacemaker cells produce? A cardiac potential or a pacemaker potential? A pacemaker potential. And remember what a pacemaker potential looks like. Be sure that you can draw a pacemaker potential. Slow dipole, fast dipole, here's my repole, slow dipole, fast dipole, there's my repole, slow dipole, fast dipole, repolarization. The frequency of these is what determines heart rate. So if I increase the frequency of them, the heart rate will go up. If I decrease the frequency of them, the heart rate will lower. Since we're dealing with the parasympathetic nervous system, we know that the heart rate is going to go down. So that means I need to have fewer or decreased frequency of these pacemakers. So notice the differences here. One difference is that slow depolarization is a lot longer. Notice the other difference. My cell now is hyperpoling, or having a longer repole, if you will. The parasympathetic nervous system lowers the heart rate, and it does that by decreasing the frequency of these pacemaker potentials. Notice I only have two pacemaker potentials here when the parasympathetic nervous system dominates. So let's look at the mechanism for how this happens. So here we have parasympathetic innervation. Since we're dealing with the parasympathetic nervous system in the heart, we know that this will be the plasma membrane of the SA and the AV nodes in the heart. We know that the receptor at the SA and the AV node is a muscarinic cholinergic receptor, and we know the neurotransmitter binding to this receptor is acetylcholine. So in step one, acetylcholine binds to your muscarinic cholinergic receptor, which then activates the G protein. Notice we have a few G proteins here. When we activate a G protein, this is causing direct coupling, not activation of a second messenger, but direct coupling. And so this is what's gonna happen with direct coupling. I'm gonna label this side over here 3A, and I'm gonna label the opposite side 3B. Let's discuss what's happening at 3A first. So in 3A, when the G protein is activated, we all know that the alpha subunit slides over and it smacks into a channel. Here it's smacking into a T-type calcium channel. What's happening is that acetylcholine is causing the suppression, the voltage-gated T-type calcium channel. Not only does it suppress a voltage-gated T-type calcium channel, what's not shown here is that it's also going to suppress the funny sodium channel. So when we say that both of these channels are suppressed, what we mean by this is that their opening is delayed. So if they have a delayed opening, we know slow dipole now takes longer. So this delayed opening causes a longer slow dipole. Now, let's look at what's going to happen in 3B. When that G protein is activated and the alpha subunit slides over, we augment the voltage-gated potassium channel. If we augment it, that means that it's opening quicker. And if it does that, then we can have a flood of potassium coming into the cell. And when you have a flood of potassium, that's going to cause repole longer, and actually the membrane will hyperpolarize. Normally in a pacemaker, we don't have hyperpolarization. But because these voltage-gated potassium channels are augmented, plus you have a delayed opening in your funny and your T-types, so the cell is hyperpolarizing and you have a longer slow dipole. So the effect of both of these then, so for 3A and 3B, if you put them together, this is going to decrease the frequency of the pacemaker action potentials. And if you decrease the frequency of the pacemaker action potentials, this will lower the heart rate. And if we lower the heart rate, that's going to lower cardiac output. So what this means is that the SA node is firing less frequently than it normally would be with parasympathetic innervation. So that concludes the video and our discussion on how the parasympathetic nervous system regulates heart rate.